Now we come to the preamble. Now, preamble is the soul of the Indian constitution, one can say, or in other words, it is the introduction to the constitution. And the preamble, which is, we the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic, and to secure to all its citizens justice, social, economic, and political, liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith, and worship, equality of status, and of opportunity, and to promote among them all fraternity, assuring the dignity of the individual and the unity and integrity of the nation. In our Constituent Assembly, this 26th day of November 1949, do hereby adopt, enact, and give to ourselves this Constitution. Now, if we take up the details, that is, we the people of India. Now, we the people of India, that means the constitution has been drawn up by people and enacted by the people through their representatives. That means that every group of people, the different groups of people that we had, they were represented. Secondly, sovereign. Sovereign means that India is a free country. There is, in our internal matters and our external matters, no external power can dictate. Next is socialist. That is, the wealth is generated socially and should be shared equally. Next is secular. That means in our country, we do not have an official religion. All religions are treated with equal respect by the government, and there is no religion that is considered to be superior or the other to be inferior. So that is the freedom given to the people. Then democratic, that means that we have adopted a form of government in which people elect their rulers and hold them accountable. We have elections, so that is a system of government that we have adopted. Then republic, that means the head of the state is an elected person, and it is not a hereditary position like in a monarchy, where after the king the son becomes the next ruler, whereas in our country, we do not follow the system of hereditary. The person is elected. Then justice. There is no discrimination between the citizens on the basis of caste, religion, and gender. That means the government works for the welfare of more for the poor people and the oppressed, so that social inequalities are reduced or minimized. So there is justice for everyone, the same. Then liberty. Liberty is the freedom to express opinions and no unreasonable restrictions on their liberty. That means the freedom to express a thought and opinion, to protest, is all that. Equality, that means all citizens are equal in matters of law. Whether you're rich or whether you're poor, law is the same for everyone. And fraternity, that is, each citizen should respect the feeling of brotherhood and be united under all circumstances.